Let us now move on to this collection called paper elements and understand how they work. You could observe from this statement here is that the paper elements are designed on the material design UI principles. So the Google follows a complete set of material design guidelines in order to implement this. You could find this particular standard here. The material design principles of Google are from the inspirations of ink and paper, and this particular site here will give you a complete orientation and the philosophy of this material design. The range of topics would include the material foundation, where there is a foundation overview, the environment, layout, navigation, color theory, topography, iconography, shape, motion, interaction and communication. Literally all aspects of the design principles is actually covered here. Let us now move on to the working with the paper elements. I have set up this paper-element.html for this with this simple code. So first we are importing this paper input .html. This is the polymer element that you are importing, and this is the place where you are actually instantiating the element. So let us head to the browser and then see how it looks like. You can observe that this paper input element has appeared here. So this is in the working condition. So let us introduce some more variants to this particular paper element.html and see how it behaves. Let us now introduce two more variants. So the second instance of this particular paper input has a label property attached to it with the username, and the third one is having a label as well as a auto validate pattern where it is only allowing the small a to small z and capital A to capital Z in these ranges, and for any number of characters. So this is a pattern that is set up here, and in case somebody violates this pattern, then this is the error message that should be triggered. So let's head to the browser and then observe the output. So you could observe that there are three instances now, and the second instance is now carrying this label called username, and the third one is actually carrying the letters only. Now just in case I violate this pattern, so you could see that there is a error message which is getting triggered here. This is how essentially the paper input element works. Apart from the paper input, there are many more other input elements. So there are 8 of them if you could look at here. And there is a paper checkbox, there is a drop down menu, there is a paper input that we have seen, there is a list box, radio buttons group, paper sliders, and then toggle button. These are the different elements which are present as part of the paper input elements. And also one more facility this documentation gives is you can choose any of these elements, and the document is very well written. And also you could observe that there is a sample code which is given here. When you execute the sample code, you could observe what kind of result that actually gets rendered to you. And also there is a demo page which is set up here. You could click this, and then you will be able to practice the codes right from here, and then get a hang of how each of these elements work. So since the number of elements are very huge, so one way of learning this quickly would be to quickly come to this documentation section and pick up any element of your choice, and then go through this documentation and then practice the demo. This is how essentially one gets control on the elements at a faster rate. Paper checkbox essentially it will give you a list of options here, out of which you could choose a few of them or unchoose a few of them, and you could also disable a particular checkbox. The paper drop down menu is a material design browser select element. So you will be able to choose out of a given list of values. So this is the drop down list box which is coming up, and you will be able to choose any of them, and this is the code that you will have to use. And the element that you need to be importing is paper drop down menu, and once you do that, you will be able to instantiate these elements with this set of values. We have already seen three examples as part of our demo for paper input, so let us proceed to the paper list box. So using a list box, you will be able to define a set of list items, and you will be able to select one of them. So there's a demo page which is available here. You could access this. So you will be able to select these things like this. So it is paper list box, which is the element name, and these are the values that you have, and then you could use that. So similarly, there are radio buttons where you will have to select only one given value out of a requisite values which is to be true, then you will use the radio button. And also it is possible to group the radios. So these are the two options that you have. And using the paper slider, you will be able to simulate a slider environment with the, for example, if you just look at, this is the slider element, so you could expand this, contract this, and because of which the value gets varied. And also you have a toggle button using which you can simulate the yes or no options, where you will provide a on-off switch that can toggle the state by tapping or dragging by the switch. So this is essentially how the toggle button works.